Well, it depends on which way I'm facing it. And
you show the shop
outside.
That's crazy. Those
people are here. I never watched it.
Watching some sort of way.
I'm always here.
Like Carlo was over there, but he's over there.
Encore, encore.
Got another 10 minutes till he comes.
Yeah. Sunday. No.
He knows better.
Yeah. Well, it is a gorgeous morning because this is the day that the
Lord has made.
And we should rejoice in.
Be glad in.
Oh, you guys are good. I love it. Oh, I'm wound up today. All right. 45 minutes for church. More like an hour and a half. We have a couple of sign-ups here for ushers and nursery. So if I'll start this over here with Debbie, can I start this with you? And ushers, when it gets to the back, can you bring it up front and we can pass it back? And those are very important things to do, by the way. So please, we ask you to help out and be ushers and help out with the nursery. Get a couple people to do nursery if you can. We appreciate it. Let's take a few minutes. Let's just thank the Lord for gives us each and every day for God and His blessings and what He does for each one of us, for our families, and for all those around us. But let us also search our hearts to see what we can do as God has done for us. Let us do for others. Let us pray.
Oh, I tell you what happened with Jesus is this.
his, that his name was John, and they did terrible things to him, and yet Jesus ended up having to bury him and so forth. But then what happened was he went away to get away from everybody and just kind of relaxed. But guess what? People kept following Jesus and following him. And so what he did was a miracle. His disciples said, send everybody home so they can have dinner. And Jesus said, no, we got enough food. So Jesus took 5 loaves and 2 fishes, and he turned them into thousands so everybody could eat. And then they could listen to Jesus and not feel hungry. And that's what Jesus does to us. He feeds us so we're never hungry if we believe in him. So always call on Jesus, knowing that he's going to spiritually inside fill you with wonder and goodness. Okay? Amen. All right. Let's come to God asking him to look within inside us. But we have to be forthright with God and ask him to forgive us of our sins. But we have to be honest with ourselves. Let us come to God and let us read the prayer of confession. Let us read.
Dear Father, I know too well that I have sinned against you and many others on this earth. But I also understand that your grace is bigger than any sin I have committed or will ever commit. I accept your provision for my forgiveness, the death of your Son Jesus on the cross. Please forgive me and fill me with your Holy Spirit. Thank you for this unspeakable gift. Amen.
One of the things I love about that prayer is I accept your provision. I accept your provision for the forgiveness of my sins. We ask God to forgive our sins. We also have to listen to him and do what he wants us to do so that we might have a better life. Let us come to God, one-on-one, each one of us, asking him to forgive us for our sins. But let us also be ready to do the things he wants us to do so that others might come to know the same Lord. Let us pray in silence. Father, we come to you today and we're truly sorry for those sins. And we ask you to send the Holy Spirit to strengthen us so that we try not to sin again, but let us listen to you and what you want us to do. And we accept all that you tell us to do. This day and every day when we are truly sorry for those sins we have committed, in Jesus' name, those sins are forgiven. Amen. Well, if you please turn with me to your Bibles, to Matthew chapter 14, verses 13 through 21. Listen and hear the word of God. What happened was Jesus was very close to John the Baptist. And yet Jesus heard and understood that John was beheaded. Terrible death. because that's what somebody wanted done. And they took John's body and they buried it, and Jesus wanted to go and kind of get away. And yet people kept following him, kept wanting him. And we do the same thing. We keep wanting him and wanting to know more about him. And he understood that. And he loved us. Verse 13 starts off, "Now when Jesus heard this about John, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. And when the crowds heard it, they followed Jesus on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them, and he cured the sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to Jesus and said, 'This is a deserted place. The hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves.' And Jesus said to them, 'They need not go away. Give them something to eat.' And they replied, 'We have nothing here but five loaves and two fish.' And Jesus said to his disciples, 'Bring here to me.' When he ordered the crowd to sit down on the grass, and taking the five loaves and two fish, he looked up to heaven, and he blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowd. All ate and were full. And they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children." So ends the reading of God's gracious and God's holy word. Incredible story. Terrible things happen to Jesus' cousin. Can you hear me? They beheaded him because somebody didn't like him and thought they were against him. So Herod had him beheaded. Jesus' cousin. He felt terrible. He just wanted to get away. Have you ever done that? Just wanted to kind of get away from it all? And not be called? That happens once in a while, I think, to every single one of us. And I've told the story before, but I'm going to tell it again because it was one of the best things that happened. A few years ago, I read the same scripture. And I came home, and I was like, "Oh, I just want to crash." And my phone started ringing. I went, "Ah!" Inside, I was probably saying, "Now what?" And I went, and Sue said, "Answer it. You love it." And it was true. And we both started cracking up because at that exact same moment, I thought of the scripture and I thought what God had called me to do. And you don't think Jesus felt the same way? He kind of wanted to get away, but he was called on by God's people. And he answered them. And he was glad to do it. By the way, I was glad to do it. But it was remarkable what he did. They came and they followed Jesus because they wanted to know about him. They wanted to know about the Father. They wanted to know about him. And we should be the same way. We should go out of our way as they did. They went out into a deserted place, a desert. And we should be able to go out into our desert and follow Jesus so that we might listen to him. Go out of our way do what he wants us to do. And Jesus said to the disciples, came to him and said, look, it's getting late. People are going to be wanting to be fed. We don't have any food. We got 5 loaves and 2 little fish. How many? 5,000 men? Not including women and children? Let's say they were 3,000 women that followed. So that's 5,000, 6,000, 8,000 people. And children? I'm sure they had more than just one. There was probably 10,000, 12,000 people there. Jesus had compassion on them. And he broke the bread and he blessed them. We heard that before, the Last Supper, where he broke the bread and gave thanks. And he told the disciples to pass them out. Pass them out. Now, if you wanted to know, there were 12 baskets left over. Baskets back in those days were huge. They fed, let's say, 13,000 people, women and children and men, from 5 loaves and 2 fish. What he is saying to us and what he's showing us is that Jesus Christ and the Father always has enough to feed you and I. There's always more than enough that Jesus has to change our lives so that we can be with him and know him. But we have to follow him. We have to go with him. We have to listen to him. We have to do what he tells us to do. And he will bless us abundantly. And there will be more than we can even think or ask. Because he is abundance is over what we can even think. Do we do that? Do we follow him out to the desert in a deserted place? What's a desert? A desert could be our inward self. We don't know where we're going. We don't know which way to turn. Have you ever been in the desert? I'm from New Mexico. There's beautiful mountains and hills and gorgeous things, but outside the mountains, there's a desert. There's a place you might have probably heard of it. It's called White Sands, New Mexico. And you go out there, a lot of times there's a lot of people, but there's times where we have gone out there and there's nobody. And there's nothing around. Nothing but sand. It is deserted and it is lonely. But not when you have somebody with you. And you always have Jesus Christ with you. And if he is with you and in you, and you do and understand and you follow him, you will never be deserted. And you will never be left alone. And you will never, ever be hungry in spirit. God will never leave you. He will never forsake you. His abundance is more than we can even think or ask. He's an all-forgiving God. And he can forgive you and I. And fill us with more food than you can even think of, spiritual. Amen? We're going to skip the next song. No, we're not. I just saw a couple people, I'm sorry, had their books open, their hymnals shut out. Let's turn to hymn number 87, Fairest Lord Jesus.
That's probably the best amen right there. Let us be thankful for what we have.
Let us get back to God, not our leftovers, but let us get back to God so that we might continue God's work in God's mission. Let us get back to Him, not only here, but also at home.
Amen.
bless you this day and every day with all that you do and all that you say. Please be seated. May our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Father in heaven, and the Holy Spirit be with each and every one of you. Amen. We have a special guest that is not with us today. That guy, of course. But Carrie's mom is not here. Marlene. Hi, Marlene. And it's Marlene's birthday, and your little boy wanted us to sing to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Love you, Mommy.
Now, Gary, I want you to turn that around so your mom can see you.
Hi, Mom. I love you.
Oh, it's fun. We love her, Mom. Go today with God. Remember, He went out of His way to feed all of us. And if He can feed with 5 loaves and 2 fishes, He can feed our souls. May the Lord bless you and be with you, now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you all for coming today. We have a little baptism right after church, but please leave, or stay with me. I don't know what I'm saying about that. Thank you for coming. I have a little.